My graduate work was at the MIT Media Lab, where I was developing and testing innovative technologies for education, basically computer games, that helped kids learn about real-world problems by encountering them in play form through the games. After that, I spent 3 years at the Harvard Graduate School of Education in the Technology and Education program lecturing, and then came here and have been here ever since. This place is kind of the ultimate ideal academic environment. This is a place that values the thinking about problems that matter in the world, and that puts good ideas before anything else. The reason that I wrote a book that's a popular press book, that's not intended just for my fellow academics, was because the issues that our schools face are too important to just be sitting in the ivory tower. We live in a world of global competition, right, where basic facts and basic skills aren't going to cut it in a global marketplace. And then increasingly people are realizing that the same technologies that create this global world of digital communications are the technologies that we need to use to prepare kids for that world. And people are starting to recognize that, you know, computer games have a lot of potential to do that. Urban Science is a game where players become urban planners to redesign a city. In the game, they become urban planners, and they do the same kinds of things urban planners do. They go on a site visit where they look at the area that they're going to be redesigning. They meet with virtual stakeholders and find out about the issues people care about. And ultimately, they put together a final plan based on the feedback from stakeholders that they get on their redesigns. And actually, in the last time we played it this past summer, the mayor came, and the players of the game presented their plans to the mayor. In Digital Zoo, players become biomechanical engineers. So they design creatures of the kind that you might see in a Pixar movie.
Professionals have a particular way of seeing the world and making decisions in that world. And young people can have that same way of looking at the world. We just need to mediate it with something.
Definitely the kids are learning to think like the professionals that they are playing as.
There are a lot of very powerful aspects to games that lead children to learn.
Everybody in our research group works together on everybody's project. It's truly collaborative.
Our focus is on the research that students are doing and that they're learning to do. And so right from day one, they're part of a research team.
One colleague might be looking at the technical side, another might be looking at the mentoring side, and so we're all kind of putting our two cents in. It's a fantastic design team.
It's a really interesting, creative, and dedicated group of students that are working together. I learn from them every day on the job.
One of the nice things about Madison is it's a really good place to be a graduate student. You know, it's a city that's very welcoming, that's very oriented towards the university, and so there are people who come for that. There are a lot of people who come specifically to, you know, because our program is so strong in what we do. And one of the nice things about our department is it's relatively small, and what that means is there's a really close relationship between students and faculty. We don't admit people, you know, just based on their scores or just based on their record. We really are admitting people because we think they're going to be part of the mix here in a positive way.